folks, the answer here in the 11th chapter of Romans, obviously, is God hasn't abandoned his people. But maybe a better question would be, has his people abandoned him?
Amen.
And that question is pertinent for you and for me today. Not has God abandoned his people. If you have a heart for God, think back to David. Did he do everything right? No. He messed up a lot. But even God called him a man after God's own heart. Why? Because he trusted God. He had faith in God. He was rebellious by nature. Same thing with Paul. But it was about this constancy of, I want to follow you. Please forgive me, God. I want to trust you. I want to follow you. I need your help. I am weak in the flesh, Lord. Strengthen me. Hold me close. Don't let me go. I pray that prayer more than anything I've ever prayed in my life. Don't let me go. If it's up to Steve, I'd be lost a long time ago. But when I pray, God, don't let me go, I know that he has a strong grip and he's going to hold on tight. You know? God loves you and he has a strong grip. But it is still up to you and to me to trust that grip, to place our faith and trust in him, and not to do it our way, but his way. His way and his way alone. The Bible's clear, God has not abandoned Israel. But it's also very clear that some of Israel has abandoned God. There's not one person on the planet that's ever been born that God didn't want them to come to know him and have a relationship with, not one. He loves everybody. He's extended those arms of mercy to every single person. But there will be a lot of people that will stand before him one day and he will say, depart from me, workers of iniquity, I never knew you. It's not because he abandoned them, it's because they chose to walk away from him and abandon his way of doing things. His life, the life exchange that he offers, Christ's life, is the only life he'll accept. It's by faith, folks. It's by faith. God has not rejected Israel. He has not rejected you. A better question to ask is, have we rejected him? And you must answer that just like I have to. And our faith each day, is it placed in him? Does it pour out of our lives and how we act and respond and live this life, our trust and faith? Or is it all about flesh? That's the message today. Would you stand with me? Praise team, we're not going to sing. Just going to close. Would y'all stand? Would you bow your heads and close your eyes? The altar is always open, of course, but each Sunday when I stand up here, I almost am certain that there's someone, at least one person in our midst that doesn't know the Lord. And it is my heart that everyone come to know him, trust him, place their faith in him. And Lord, it is not, people, it is not about whether the Lord still loves you or not. He will always love you. The question is, are we loving him back? Are we trusting him and placing our faith in him and he alone? So I would ask you just for a moment, just as you bow your heads and close your eyes, just to pray and ask the Lord, have I rejected you? Am I rejecting you in my life, or am I living a life out of faith in you? Does my life reflect my faith in my Lord and my Savior? I'm going to hush for just a moment. Just spend some time. I'm so grateful that we serve a God with a strong grip. We serve a God who holds on to his children and teaches us to trust you, to follow you, to yield and submit to you. Lord, I ask you to give us strength to hold us close to you, Don't let us go, Lord. Even when we think we have a better way, send someone our way, Lord, to speak the gospel, to give us the scripture, to point us back to you and remind us that there is no better way. Jesus says, I am the way. That's the best way. Father, help us in this crazy world we live in, this confusing time and messed up society. Help us, Lord, to be steadfast and immovable in our relationship with you, that our light would shine in the world we live in because we are directly connected with the source every day, moment by moment. Thank you, Lord, for not abandoning us when we mess up, when we sin, when we just get in ourselves, Lord. Thank you for being more consistent and gracious and merciful than that. And Father, I pray that you wouldn't let us go. Hold us close. Lord, if we try to run away, shut us down. Stop us in our tracks. Keep us close, Lord. I pray that there wouldn't be one person that's hearing this today that would ever choose just to walk away or to place their faith and trust in something else or someone else, but that we would yield to you in your way, your heart. What a privilege it is to walk with you each day. Lord, thank you for your consistent, compassionate, merciful love. How you pursue us. We need you more than ever, Lord. Father, as always, I ask you to pour out your presence in our lives. Sustain us in your will and your way, Father. May the Lord now bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you. And be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance on you and give you peace. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hey, can we sing happy birthday to Miss Michelle? Michelle, come on up here. Sue, can you give us a note or two? 55.
I want you to
stand
here beside me.
I'll stand beside you. Okay. All right. Good.